भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति 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 ॐ समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् सच्चिदानन्दरूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादिहेतवे तापत्रयविनाशाय श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः हरि ओम् सल्युटेशन्स् टु आल् सो फस्ट् चाप्टर् इस् द अधिकारी लक्षण एण्ड् वी सॉ हौ परीक्षित राजा his vairagya and also how he comes under the influence of Kali, and he ill-treats one Mahatma and he gets a curse from the sun that on the seventh day Takshak will come and kill him. So what does Parikshit Raja do? He doesn't despair, he doesn't victimize himself, he doesn't say this is unfair, no resistance. What does he do? He hands over the kingdom to his grandson Janmejay. He hands over the son, his kingdom to Janmejay, his son, and he withdraws and he goes quietly in solitude, ekant, to remember the Lord. And there come so many rishis also, and finally there Shukdev Maharaj also arrives. So Shukdev Maharaj, when he comes there, they welcome him. And Parikshit Raja has asked him question. So we are at the end of this book one, chapter 1, verse 37, in discourse 19. Ata prichhami samsiddhim yoginam paramam gurum purushasyeha yatkaryam mriyamanasya sarvatha. So the question he has asked is, in general, what should be done by people to attain fulfillment? Samsiddhim yoginam paramam. You are the greatest of the yogis. Please tell us what to do to achieve fulfillment. And in specific, mriyamanasya purushasya iha yat karyam. What should a person who is going to die do? Sarvatha. At all times. Not just at the moment of death. Now when we say one who is going to die means whom?
All of us.
Simple. All of us are going to die. All of us are going to die meaning what? We are going to die in the sense the body is one day going to drop dead. Otherwise we are dying at this moment also. Every minute one is dying only. Meaning it is perishable. Every single moment life is ebbing away. Body is moving closer and closer. So what should be done by such a person? Yat shrotavyam atho japyam yat kartavyam nirbhi prabho. What should be heard? Shrotavyam. What should be repeated? Japyam. Yat kartavyam. What action should be done by the human beings? Nirbhi. O Lord. Smartavyam, what should be remembered? Bhajaniyam, what should be sung about? And what should not be done? Viparyayam. So it appears he is asked only one thing, that what should a dying person do? But with that he has asked all these, what should be heard, what should be repeated, what should be sung, what should be remembered, what should be done, and what should not be done also. And he tells Shukadev Maharaj that please have some grace on us, because you don't stay more than the time taken to milk a cow in one place. Na lakshyatehi avasthanam api godohanam kvachit. So you please have some mercy on us, have some compassion on us, and please tell us about all these. So that's where the first chapter ended. And we know that Sutaji is telling all this to the sadhus who have assembled in Naimisharanya. So Sutaji continues there saying that Shukadevji, when he was asked these questions, now this is how he gave the answer. So now the answer that he gave, that the second chapter starts there. Now this first portion of this second chapter is very, very beautiful. We will do every verse. Shri Shuka Uvacha. Variyan eshate prashnaha.
Variyan eshate prashnaha.
Kritao loka hito nrupa.
Kritao loka hito nrupa.
Atma vit sammata pumsam.
Atma vit sammata pumsam.
Shrotavyadishu yaparaha.
Shrotavyadishu yaparaha.
See, Shukadev Maharaj, he doesn't stay in a place more than time taken to milk a cow. He could have given the answer very quickly saying, remember the Lord at the time of death. Over. Nothing more is required. Like the great sadhus, the great masters, they will give the answer. If a disciple asks the question and the disciple is Uttamadhikari, the answer is given, Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi, any such one Mahavakya will be told and the job is done. No elaborate thing is not required. But that elaboration is done for whom? For the rest of the people. Parikshit Raja is Uttam Adhikari already. He doesn't need. But Parikshit Raja becomes an instrument and through him Shukadevji is given this knowledge to all. So the style that he is going to follow is this, that he will explain. In short, he will already say, okay, this is what has to be done. And then the whole Bhagavatam will be an explanation of this. So just like in the Upanishad it happens, the Uttam Adhikari is given the knowledge right in the beginning. Then it's an elaboration of that same thing. Now here he begins by praising the question of Parikshit Raja. Variyan eshate prashna. Your question is very auspicious, blessed. And krito loka hitandrapa. It has been asked with the intention of the welfare of the whole world, of all the beings. O king. And atmavit sammata pumsam. And it is also in line with the knowers of the self. Meaning the knowers of the self also approve of such a question. Shrotavyadishu ya paraha. Of whatever needs to be heard and understood, Shrotavyadishu, this is the supreme. Yat paraha. Meaning the reply that he is going to give, that is the supreme, that has to be heard. Of so many things that we hear in the world, this is something to be heard, the reply that he is going to give. So the question also, so one Uttam Adhikari has met a great master. Shukadev Maharaj's glory we have seen little bit earlier, that he is an embodiment of Vairagya, embodiment of Jnana, an embodiment of Bhakti. All the three are there in him. Any one which is not there, then the other two become incomplete. And that's the context we are seeing in Bhagavatam. That Bhakti Mata is young and Jnana and Vairagya have become old. And Jnana and Vairagya, to strengthen them, this whole Bhagavatam is given. So he is an embodiment of Jnana, Bhakti, Vairagya. Shukadev Maharaj is an embodiment of that, is the Guru. Brahmanishta Guru. Shrotriya Guru also, because he studied the scripture from his teacher, from his father, Vedavyasji. Especially Bhagavatam, he learned from Vedavyas. Then the disciple is Parikshit Raja. Parikshit Raja also is an embodiment of Vairagya. He left the kingdom. He is a mumukshu because he wants only mukti. His question is nothing else except this one, that what should a dying man do? So he has Vairagya. He is a mumukshu, tivra mumukshu at that. And he has bhakti for the Lord also. When Shukadev Maharaj comes, he tells him that without, you know, we are blessed that you are here, and definitely Krishna is pleased with me that you have come here, and because of my parents and grandparents, Abhimanyu was protected by, Parikshit was protected by Krishna Bhagavan. Abhimanyu and then Arjun. So Krishna loved both of them. So he says, because of them, a person like me is having your company. So he has lot of bhakti for Lord Vishnu. One of his names is what?
Vishnurata.
So now Guru is an established Mahatma in Jnana Bhakti Vairagya. Shishya has highest level of Jnana Bhakti and Vairagya. Just little bit of initiation required, he will realize. So that's why the first chapter was Adhikari Skan. Now to such a person, the teacher is replying. So he says, your question is very good, because this question is not meant only for him, it is also meant for everyone. So he says, Loka Hito Nripa. And why is it said, Atma Vit Sammata Pumsam? The knowers of the self also approve of this question. Because people think that this knowers of self don't have bhakti, or this people who are walking path of jnan, they don't believe in God, they don't believe in Ishwar, they don't believe in, you know, birth and death also, because knower of self is unborn, undying. So what is this birth, what is this death, and what should be done at the time of death? How does it even matter? This whole thing is unreal, illusion. But here he says it is approved by them also. Why? Atma Vit Sammata Pumsam. Because the Atma is nothing but that one Lord only. There is no difference, actually speaking. When we say this world is an illusion, see, one very important point to understand. Illusion also has different levels, and illusion also creates different responses in us. So when we see a snake, what will happen to us? Yes. Snake and rope. If we don't see the rope, we see the snake, what happens? Yes. Fear will arise. If we see the silver in the seashell, what will arise? Greed will arise. Both are illusions only. So when we see an illusion, there will still be a response in the mind, because we are seeing the illusion. We are still at the body level. It is real. The knowledge that this is an illusion will make me not run behind it. When I don't run behind it, then I can turn within and see what is the truth. Then I am out of it. Then there is no questioner, there is no guru who is answering, and there is no transaction that is happening. But when I am at this level, then we don't have to worry, kyare, this is something else, that bath of devotion is something else, jnana is something else. And unfortunately, so many people who study Vedant, instead of increasing their bhakti for Bhagwan, they think that by studying Vedant, now I become free from bhakti. I don't have to worship God. I don't need to believe in God. Because I am that. If I am that, then why should I worship? Are? If I am that, that God does not eat. But you are eating, no? You are eating food, you are drinking, you are sleeping. That Bhagavanto doesn't eat, drink, sleep. As absolute self, what? Does it eat anything? It sees without eyes, it hears without ears. You try doing it. Pashyame chakshu sashrunomi akarnaha. So our identification is still here at this level. If jnan will not bring bhakti in the heart, that jnan is useless. And bhakti does not make me want to know the swarup of that Lord, that bhakti also is incomplete. So he says your question is approved by the knowers of the self also. Those who want to know that immortal self, they also want to know how to get out of this identification with the body. And bhakta definitely wants to know how to become one with Bhagwan. What should I remember at the time of death? So, atmavit sammata pumsam. Shrotavyadishu yah paraha. And of so many things that are to be heard in this world, what is the supreme? Meaning of all the knowledge. See, shrotavyadishu means all knowledge we gain by listening. No, Swamiji, we gain by reading also. That came there how? Into the book. After somebody heard it, somebody wrote it, no? One. Two, even when I am reading, if I read loudly, I can hear, no? No, I will read mentally. Okay, read mentally. No problem. But 90% of knowledge comes only by shruti, by listening only it keeps coming. So of all knowledge that I have to gain, shrotavyadishu yatparaha means of all knowledge that I have to gain, which is the best knowledge? The reply that he is going to give, that is the best knowledge. The knowledge of the self or knowledge of Bhagavan, that's what we call. So shrotavyadishu yatparaha. So then he says, shrotavyadini rajendra nrinam santi sahasrashaha. Apashyatam atma tattvam griheshu grahamedhinam. So he says here, there are so many things that have to be heard. Shrotavyadini rajendra nrinam santi sahasrashaha. There are thousands of things to be heard in this world. Because so many fields are there, so much subjects are there, so many things I have to learn. And all our children, we are doing that or not? Send them. Pack their schedule. We never asked our parents, what time should I sleep and what time should I get up? We just got up and we just slept. Today the mom controls everything. Now you time to sleep, now you should see TV only 20 minutes, now you time to eat, now you time to get up. Now you go to this class, now tennis class, now chess class, now handwriting class, now salsa class, now this, now that. Are they taking children to salsa? Itna chota chota bacha. I don't have a problem, I'm the same. They go. All classes. And then they will say, no, religion we don't want. So they will not put them into Balvihar or any other thing. And the best knowledge which they are supposed to get, and that age when they are supposed to get it, when their mind is so fresh, they won't give. Then the teenager, he becomes non-believer. Then they will come, Swamiji, please help, do something. Mera beta hai na, you're gone. I said, you went first. You went first in your thinking only when he was a kid, you should have introduced. Now so we have Shishu Vihar also. After 13, 14, then what will you do? We'll try something, no doubt, but it's like doing mending. When the bending was happening, that time you didn't do anything. That time you allowed it to do whatever. Now you are telling us to mend and then bring him into straight thing. So this is where he is saying, no, Shrotavyadini Santi Sahasrasha. There's thousands of things to be heard, but in that, what is the main thing? Apashyatam Atma Tattvam. You should know the self. That who am I? See, Apashyatam Atma Tattvam Griheshu Grihamedhinam. So now he says, of the people who are attached to their home, griheshu, and griha medhi means a grihasthi who has to do panchamahayagnya. That's the kartavya of a grihasthi. So he says, engaged in performing the five great sacrifices enjoined on the householders and are blind to the truth of the self. They don't know the self. They will keep hearing everything else. That which is supposed to be known, that is not known. Rest of the thing, all one knows. So what is that which is supposed to be known? This Atma Tattvam is supposed to be known. So Griheshu Griha Medhinam. Now what are these five sacrifices? Panchamaha Yajna is a concept of living in harmony with the whole universe. Panchamaha Yajna. So first Yajna is Deva Yajna. Now, Deva Yajna is done by Agnihotra in the Vedic days, I am saying. In today's context, the Deva Yajna can be our Ishta Devata's Upasana, Puja, Bhajan, Dhyan, Japa, all those. To express our gratitude to the Supreme Lord, and Vedic times, Deva Yajna also meant to be in tune with the phenomenal forces in the universe. By offering ahutis in the Agnihotra, we sustain the devatas. Devatas further nurture this universe. They are the phenomenal forces. So, what did the Gita say? Devan bhavayata nena te deva bhavayantu vaha. You propitiate the devatas and they will get strengthened by your ahutis. And in turn, they will bless you with what you need. So, mutually cooperating with each other. Parasparam bhavayanta shreya param avapsyatha. Both of you attain the good. So, that was Deva Yajna. Now today to where we do Deva Yajna, phenomenal forces, existence also we don't believe. And we think that this is all inert thing, the ocean is just water. We don't think that this is Varun Devata. Our culture says it is Varun Devata, who is the presiding deity of the ocean. Vana Devata, Ganga Maya, like that, there is all Devatas who are presiding over this whole phenomenal forces. So, ahutis are offered to them. And the idea is through them, it is one consciousness which is appearing in this whole universe. So there is nothing called inert. Now these things we won't accept. Then the science will bring it in their language, then we will accept. Go to Google and do your research on this experiment called double slit experiment. Double slit experiment. That is your homework. And you come back and tell me what you understood from that. Double slit experiment. Quantum physics experiment it is. It's very nice. So anyway, my point is this, that Deva Yajna is this to be in tune with the Supreme Lord, to express our gratitude as well as to offer our contribution to the phenomenal forces for them to take care of the universe. You see, this Vedic vision is so beautiful. Now, when we want to be environment friendly, what will we do? Today we have become environmental conscious more. Earlier people were much more. Then today we think we are very environmental conscious. They are much more environmental conscious. But anyway, when we want to be environment conscious, what will we do? Plant some tree, don't use plastic, save water, all those things, no? Which is good. But what is it actually? That is the expression at the environment level, which is the effect. Deva Yajna is nurturing the cause. That those devatas who are taking care of the universe, offer ahutis for them to sustain them, then they will take care of the universe. Apart from whatever you and I have to do for the universe, at the gross level, we should definitely do. But Deva Yajna is at the subtle level. One can do at both levels. Gayatri Mantra also one can chant. And you can offer. See, today, we may not be able to do long, long, elaborate Vedic rituals. But there are people even today who do Agnihotra. They have small kunda. And they will have samed sticks. They will chant the mantra. They will offer. If you feel you can do that, do that. If you think that is difficult to do, then chant the Gayatri Mantra, look at the sun, offer the water, and when you offer it, offer it for the devatas and say Indraya swaha idam namama, Varunaya swaha idam namama, Agnaya swaha idam namama. You can do that. So Deva Yagna is the first one. But before I explain the other four, what is the concept behind these five yagnas, we should know. As grihasthis, when we live, see, a brahmachari has, the main kartavya of the brahmachari is to study and gain knowledge. And brahmachari does Ishvara upasana, guru upasana, shastra adhyayan. Then one comes to grihastha life. Now the responsibility is to take care of the society, take care of the family. Duties are there to be performed. Then there will be work in the world. Now when we work in the world, there will be some rag, some dvesh, some himsa will happen, some things keep happening. And our existence itself is going to destroy so many things in this universe. The air that we breathe, the water that we drink, the food that we eat, that also is going to destroy. When we walk, so many living beings are getting destroyed. So now, how do I replenish the universe with all that which I have consumed? Panchamaha Yajna is because of the debt that we have. To fulfill that debt, we are doing the Panchamaha Yajna. So a person doesn't live with the attitude of the universe is there for me to exploit. The person lives in the attitude of gratitude that because of the universe I am surviving, and because of my existence I am causing harm to the universe. One point. So how do I replenish back? What can I do to ensure that in some way I compensate for the resources that I am consuming? So the Panchamaha Yajnas are done. Second is, so many things which are happening by my existence unconsciously, the karma that is generated by it. See, karma has happened and karma phala also will come. But now I am not the karta for it, because kartritva bhav is not there, but it is happening. Creatures are getting destroyed. So to offset that, again these Panchamaha Yajnas are done. Ki whenever these beings are getting consumed, destroyed, etc., the dosha of that should not come to us. Because beings are destroyed, unknowingly also. So to ensure that, we give back. So Panchamaha Yajna is meant for that. And also because the culture which has been passed on to us by the rishis, by our family, by the parents, etc., to sustain that culture, every day when I do the Panchamaha Yajnas, I will remember that. So I will be culturally connected and rooted. That's one more reason why one does that. So it's a duty for the grihasthi. For the brahmachari, it is not the duty yet. Because when once one marries, then one gets the adhikara to do proper Vedic rituals. You see, a human, so when people say so many things about why only men are allowed to do and all that, they don't see the completeness. And they talk about something which they have just heard here and there. Man and woman are considered equal in the Veda. Till the man does not get married, he doesn't have full adhikar to do the rituals also. And the woman will be sitting next to him and both will do ahutis. Otherwise they cannot do. You remember in Ramayana what Bhagwan Ram did? He put the gold murti of Sitaji besides him. Because the wife is still there. Wife has not died. And when wife passes away, then certain rituals man cannot do. And then people say that, you know, men, only a son is required because son will take the naraka gati, the son will save from naraka gati. Tum nama naraka trayate iti putraha. But that same etymology applies to putri also. Pum nama naraka trayate iti putri. So it's not that only if I get a man then I will be saved from hell. We all are wrong notions about the culture. Vedic culture doesn't say all this. Some pandit, some brahmin, somebody would have done it. And then it's gone degenerated. The only thing is the putri goes to the other gotra. So gotra may change. But otherwise it doesn't make any difference. It's all wrong notions.
Swamiji, for people who don't have children, what are they supposed to do?
So they have different other things that they do. For them, their sadgati, etc., all this Bhagwan's name and the kartavya karma, that will take care of them. If there is somebody in the family who can do it for them, that is another alternative. Otherwise, not to worry so much. If nobody is there, then what happens to us? This is a system created here for passing on of the culture. Shraddha is also meant for that. Apart from whatever the departed soul needs at that point in time, the people who are remaining here, they can do. So, the somebody else in the family can help and they can do and it will help them.
Every Shraddha you do, the Adhikar always asks, and he always gives that for all those in your family, any ancestors who have not had children. He always gives. He asks also, if you know the names, give. Otherwise, amok. General.
Correct.
He uses the word amok.
Correct.
Correct. So everybody is taking
care. Yeah. So, first yajna is Deva yajna. Second yajna is Rishi yajna. Now, how do I do Rishi Yajna? Study the Shastra, understand and share. Both are our duties, Swadhyaya and Pravachan. And this is told in the convocation address also to the Brahmachari who is getting into Grahastha Ashram. Swadhyaya Pravachan Echa, 21 times or more it comes in Taittiriya Upanishad. And then in that convocation address, you know, he says, Swadhyaya Pravachanabhyam na Pramaditavyam, do not postpone study and sharing. This is one of the reasons why our culture went through decadence is because we stopped both. Study also we stopped, sharing also we stopped. And today we have so many Devi groups in this South Bombay. We are studying regularly and because we have so many Devi groups because some of them who have studied have come forward to share. Now those of you who are studying for a long time now, start sharing. Kitna time we will keep receiving. When we start sharing, then we will understand how much we understand and how much we don't understand. But that's where my problem is, Swamiji. When I don't understand, you know, then what happens to the other person? Leave it to that person, Prarabdha. Bhagwan will give proper guidance. Don't worry. You prepare sincerely. You ensure that your clarity is correct. If you are really not having certain clarity, then don't jump into sharing. But otherwise, study and start sharing. Start a class. And I'm not saying do it only for elders. You can do Shishu Vihar. We are having Shishu Vihar Sevak training. You can teach small children. Such a joy it is to teach children. Small children. And your vairagya also will be tested in that. Expectation, you know. You expect the child will sit in front of you and listen nicely, it will not happen. 2-year-old fellow, how much is going to listen to you? He'll look here, there, everywhere, but impression is going in the head. So teach Shishu Vihar children, Bal Vihar children. Which is our date, Shishu Vihar Sevak training?
Thursday.
23rd Jan, Thursday, at Church Gate only, 9:30 to 1. There are so many classes in Mumbai of Shishu Vihar, but we need more sevikas. You don't have to apply any, don't have to be threatened by those children at all. If they ask a question, then what will I do? Don't worry, get trained and start teaching. It's not like teenagers class or a youth class, pata nahi kya puch lenge ye log. So teach them Shishu Vihar, Bal Vihar, Yuva Kendra, Devi group, study group, any level. Rishi Rina it is. How much these rishis have sacrificed for us to even gain this knowledge? And every one of us can keep saying, you know, our culture is declining, you know, the youth are looking this side, that side, we don't know how to pass on the culture. Now, we can do something, no, proactively when we study and we share. Otherwise, how much will we will only go on talking. So, Deva Yajna, then Rishi Yajna. Then third is Bhuta Yajna. Not Bhuta Yajna, sorry, that will come fourth. Pitru Yajna. Pitru Yajna is the third one. Pitru Yajna is the offering of gratitude to the Pitrus. So remember the Pitrus, especially during the Shraddha time. And also remember that Shraddha is not done only at the departure of the people. There are auspicious Shraddha also. Nandi Mukha Shraddha is there. Like that, there are other Shraddha. So at the time of birth of a child in your house, or some marriage ceremony, or any good auspicious occasions, also Shraddha is done to express gratitude to the ancestors. You ask your Panditji, he will tell you more details. But people have associated Shraddha only with death. Bhagwan Ram was born and Dashrath Maharaj did Nandimukh Shraddha. So there are Shraddhas which are there for auspicious periods also to express gratitude to the masters, to the great Pitrus, everyone. And Pitru Yajna also is living up to the traditions and the culture that the family has been following. Some things which we don't know the significance of, we should try to find the significance of before discarding and discontinuing. If something is really superstitious, then you discard. But otherwise, don't discard. Find out why they did so many things and leave. Because to build a culture takes a long time. To destroy the culture is just simple. Just stop doing it. 2 minutes, it will be finished. After that, nobody will follow that and generations will not know it also. So, Pitru Yajna is by these two. Then comes Manushya Yajna. Manushya Yajna is, they call Manushya Yajna or Nru Yajna. Nru means Nara. Nru Yajna or Manushya Yajna. That is through Atithi Devo Bhava. Now, Pitru Yajna includes not only the ancestors who have departed. Pitru Yajna includes mother, father, all of them. So, to treat them with respect also is Pitru Yajna. To take care of them in old age also is Pitru Yajna. You know that, tell them, I am putting you in our old age home, now you take care of yourself. Manushya Yajna is all the other society members, neighbors, guests, all of them who come, treat them well, with respect, love, all that. Manushya Yajna. Have proper vyavahar in the different relationships that we have. And last is Bhuta Yajna. So Bhuta Yajna is for the other creatures. So in different ways Bhuta Yajna is done. By taking care of the environment, planting more trees, not polluting the rivers. And different ways how they celebrate the festivals of in nature. Then in the olden days when we used to eat food, one sits on the ground and the houses used to be mud houses and all that. So before they eat food, they will take out little bit, three morsels they will put. So one is for the crow, one is for the cow, one is for the dog. And then one more is put for this small ants and these other creatures. In different ways, one can, basic idea is to take care of the beings, the environmental aspect. That is Bhuta Yajna. So, five types of yajnas, these are mandatory for the grahasthi. Because many things which we do will create negative karma. Some selfishness, some greed, some fighting in the world, rag, dvesh, all that is there. That will create negative karma. Now, this Panchama Yajna is not to offset the negative karma, but it is to create the punya karma. Don't think it will offset, because karma doesn't work by offset. The negative karma, negative result will come. Positive karma, positive result will come. So positive karma has to be strengthened. So on a daily basis, I have to strengthen the positive karma. So daily basis, Pancha Mahayagna is done. So for such a person, that's why the Bhagavatam here is saying that for such a grihasthi who has duties, but who doesn't know apashyatam atma tattvam, what is that which should be heard? So your question which is there is a beneficial question for the whole world also, because everybody will know then ki what should be focused upon even while doing all these Pancha Mahayagnas. Because without knowing this, how one is living the life? See, this next line is a very hard hitting line. Nidraya hriyate naktam. Vyavayena chavavayaha. Divacharthe haya rajan. Kutumba bharane nava. Nidraya hriyate naktam. In the night one spends away time in sleep and copulation. Vyavayena va. Life goes in that. What does one do in the day? Diva cha artha ihaya rajan. In the daytime, one is desiring wealth for kutumba bharane nava and taking care of the family, meaning daily bread and butter and then pursuit of wealth and prosperity, that takes away. So, meaning what? Artha and kama. Full life goes in artha and kama only. Artha becomes goal of life, kama becomes goal of life, and life just goes. Where dharma, where moksha, what one thinks about, where is the time? And if you ask them, why don't you come to satsang? No, no, right now I'm very busy. Okay, very busy. The time will come at one point, one will realize. Whenever that Punya Uday happens, then what to do? One has to wait till that time. So generally, if one thinks how the life goes, it goes in these two only, artha and kama. Dharma itself one doesn't follow in pursuit of artha and kama. Ideally, one should follow dharma in pursuit of artha and kama. If I follow dharma in pursuit of artha and kama, mind will become purified. Immediately, jignyasa will come, one will strive for moksha. But now, how will I follow dharma? In the earlier days, dharma, artha, kama, moksha, that was the sequence. Why? Because in the first 25 years, they used to study. 25 years when they study, they will get the knowledge of dharma, and of course they know how to pursue their life and earn prosperity and wealth and expertise in a field and all that they will learn, secular and spiritual knowledge. Today what has happened in education? Pursuit of artha and kama. What is the end goal? Some 7-figure salary, 10-figure salary, something. And then enjoy. Dharma to is gone out. In the name of education and pseudo-secularism, dharma to is kicked out only. So artha and kama, full on. Then they will say, world has become very stressful. Very good. What will happen? It will become stressful only. Because you remove dharma from it. Then the mind is got stuck in artha and kama. Our culture said you pursue artha and kama on the basis of dharma. Dharma viruddha bhuteshu kamosmi bharatarshabha. I am that desire which is not opposed to dharma. Now nobody said don't pursue artha and kama, but pursue them with dharma. Then it will become a means of purification. Without dharma, that artha and kama binds, totally binds. Now can you imagine life after life one is doing this? So when he is saying that loka hito nripaha, these 2-3 verses are an elaboration of that word, loka hito nripaha, that your question is in the benefit of the world. For the world it will be beneficial. Why? Because generally we are spending time like this only, artha and kama. How much time in a day one remembers the Lord? One sits for Shravan of the Bhagwan's glory or remembering the Lord sitting. What he said, na? Kim Japyam, Kim Smartavyam, Kim Kartavyam, all that. Very less time goes in those things. Ideally, what should happen is those things must be done first, and then in the balance time one is supposed to live, earning wealth, etc. If you see the earlier vision of the people, the house belongs to whom? House belongs to Bhagwan, and I am a servant of that Lord. So I will serve the Lord first, take care of whatever has to be done, then go out, work and come back. That is the vision. Now this is Nidraya Hriyate Naktam Vyavayena Chavavayaha. And life goes in this, Vayaha. Life fully goes. In sleep, in pleasure, in pursuit of wealth. So he says, Deha Patya Kalatradishu Atma Sainyeshu Asat Swapi Tesham Pramatto Nidhanam Pashyannapi na Pashyati. This is the tragedy. Where he says here that maddened by affection for those that are intimately connected with oneself, that is the body, progeny, wife and so on, unreal as they are, one fails to visualize their end, though actually witnessing it. One knows that they are also perishable, the progeny and the wife and all of them. This body also is perishable. Deep down one knows it, but one denies it. Denial mode. You know, people say he is in a denial mode. We are to constantly in denial mode. Full time we are in denial mode ki one day we are going to die. Though we are seeing people dying everywhere, all around us. For some time it will hit us also. Ki what is all this about? What are my true priorities I need to sort out? But then some other desires will come up. And then we will postpone saying, right time will come for it. Right now I need to do all this. Again the rut of life takes over. So denial mode, full time. So he says, Pashyan api na pashyati. Deha patya kalatradi. Meaning the children, the wife, all of them. Kalatradishu. Atma sainyeshu asatswapi. They are unreal. Undial in the sense, here we are not talking from Vedan standpoint of undial, they don't exist. From that standpoint, of course, they don't exist. But here undial meaning perishable. Tesham pramatto, but still intoxicated. Nidhanam pashyannapi na pashyati. See, even though one sees that they are perishing, still one doesn't see that there is an imperishable truth. Am I focusing on that or not? Life goes in that. Hence, he concludes this portion saying, Tasmat Bharata Sarvatma Bhagavan Ishvaro Harihi Shrotavya Kirtitavyascha Smartavyaschechata Bhayam. This line should be underlined. Hence, O Bharata Sarvatma, that supreme Atma of all the beings, is Bhagavan, is the Lord, is Ishvara, is a supreme Creator, and who is he? Harihi, that Supreme Lord. Because his question was, what should be heard, what should be remembered, what should be spoken about? He says, you should do that. Shrotavya Kirtitavyascha, hear about the Lord, sing the glory of the Lord, Smartavya, and remember the Lord. Smartavyascha, Ichchata Abhayam, if you want fearlessness. Vairagya will bring fearlessness and true bhakti will also bring fearlessness. Rest, everything in the world is filled with fear only. Because it is all going to be a product of attachment. So the more one remembers, every single day, did I remember the Lord or not? Did I hear the glory of the Lord or not? Did I speak about the Lord or not? These three things at least one can do. If you want a modern adaptation of it, you say, every day did I post something about Bhagwan on Facebook or not? Instagram story. Something about Bhagwan I should post. What is wrong in that? Karo. Every day something about the Lord I will post. In that way you give up, in that way you are discharging your Rishi Rina also. Because so many people will see your story and they will say, "Acha, no, no, Swamiji, that is for your story. Our story, if I put every day, they will say, what, you are going to become some sadhu, sannyasi or something. Don't worry, they are anyway unreal." That's what he said. Bhagwan alone is real. Huh?
They also start posting that to you. I mean, if something shareable is there, they'll give you that. Huh.
Sometimes secretly they will not put on their story. They know okay, you are somebody who will understand, so they will put one nice spiritual message to you. They will not put on the main story. But at least they know there's somebody whom I can go to, and when time comes, they will also change. I know some youngsters who refuse to put, you know, on one day in one of the Yuvavir course only, and this person has grown from Balvihar, is not some new person. Absolutely new person, you still understand. They have grown from Balvihar. So, Guru Purnima came. Not Guru Purnima, August 3rd. So, we gave a simple activity to all of them. That you have to post a selfie with the picture of Gurudev. And put a favorite quote of yours of Gurudev. This youngster refused to put, saying, "I will not put." Why? Because I will be branded. I will be branded by my friends. I will not put. I said, "Okay, don't put, no problem. It's your choice. We are giving you an exercise." By the end of that Yuvavir course, that Yuvavir is posting everything everywhere. And saying that you brought me close to Gurudev, I'm very grateful, this course happened, this, that, phalana, dekhna, all that. In the beginning they are like that, "No, I will not put," because perception, no? How society perceives is very important. At the end of it though, they understood so many things so clearly that is the half of perception game is all manipulated, it's not real. So what are we thinking about so much? But that perception change has to come. You were saying something?
On that person's hours, I'm not allowed to do any other job but what that person is paying me for. So if I am 24 hours in his house,
correct,
then 24 hours I'm answerable to what I'm doing.
Correct.
If I have that attitude, it just completely changes everything.
Definitely.
It's just like if I have an elder in the house and I walk out, I have to inform that person that I'm going.
Correct.
Even it has to be 2 minutes, be like, I'm going to the market, whatever. Like with his house, I'm answerable all the time.
Correct. You know, Bharatji used to do that. Tulsi Ramayana, it is said that Bharatji used to go every morning to the Padukas. And Padukas will speak to him. He will ask, "Oh Lord, what is the order for today? What should I do?" And he will get one list. Then he will finish that, he will come back, at the end of the day he will report, "Bhagwan, this happened, this didn't happen." He will report. That is his bhav also. And we should, for us we may like, "Are, hum to poochte, humko kuch pata nahi chalta hai." It is nothing like that, because that's our bhav is not there. Aayega, yeah, I'm telling you. I don't think your paduka will have mouth and it will start speaking like this. It will come to you from within. Intuition will come or some signal will come. You will know. There though it is said, really paduka used to talk to him. Meaning he would hear Bhagwan's voice in his heart. So it will come. What is there? The bhav has to be there. Ki Bhagwan, you please tell me, what should I do? Do you think answer won't come? It will 100% come. You try every day, you go tell the Lord, this is my work, today I am going to do this work. Before you sleep, report, this is your work, this much was done. Over, likes and dislikes will go away. You know, karma yoga will happen very easily. So practical means are so many. Now it depends on us how much we will apply. So here it is. So shrotavyaha, kirtitavyaha, smartavyascha, ichchatam, abhayam. Ichchata abhayam. Those who want fearlessness. Then he says, etavan sankhya yoga abhyam, swadharma parinishthaya, janmalabha parapumsam, ante narayana smritihi. This last line is very famous, Ante Narayana Smriti. So many people keep quoting Ante Narayana Smriti. That what should be remembered at the end? Ante Narayana Smriti. But this Ante Narayana Smriti comes where? Comes when? Only when the other things are done. Sankhya Yoga Abhyam. Swadharma Nishtha. Swadharma Parinishthaya. This all this if I follow, then Narayana Smriti will come at the end. It will not come just like that. People think I can do anything and at the end of the life, suddenly I'll remember Bhagwan and I will become free. That will not happen. The mind will remember what one has remembered through the life. At the end also. So now how do I live through the life? So he says that Sankhya Yoga Abhyam. Sankhya is self-knowledge here. Yoga, Sankhya Yoga Abhyam. So what you can, so this word Sankhya and Yoga can be split as Sankhya Yoga Abhyam because it's dual number. So Sankhya and Yoga. So Sankhya is the self-knowledge and Yoga is perform the yoga shastra. So if every day I am able to do some yoga or unite with the Lord, withdraw the attention from the BMI, contemplate on the Lord. So that is Sankhya Yoga Abhyam. And while living in the world, what should I do? Swadharma Parinishthaya. Engage in Swadharma, not Paradharma. What is my duty I should do and what I truly love, I should do that. Swadharma Parinishthaya. Then Janmalabha Parapumsam. The greatest benefit of this human birth in this life are these three things. Sankhya Yoga Abhyam, Swadharma Nishtha and Narayana Smriti. Because, you see in the earlier line what was said, na? Sleep, sense pleasure, pursuit of wealth, taking care of the family. All these four are done by animals also. There's nothing new that we are doing. No, but we have refined ways of enjoyment. That's all. They don't have refined ways. You have refined ways. Apart from that, nothing. They are also doing all the four. For us, wealth will be money. Ants will gather some other food and stock it. What else is the difference? So, all the four. So, when he says, Janmalabha Parapumsam, what is the greatest benefit of a human life? Is Narayana Smriti. To remember Bhagwan only. Naam dhan ka khazana badhate chalo. That's the real wealth. That's a human life. Because bhoga vritti is there in all the other yonis. A human life also, if I'm living with bhoga pradhan jivan, what is the point? It's useless. Bhagavad etc. to goes on to tell us that animals also remember Bhagwan. Gajendra remembered Bhagwan or not? So animal also remembers Bhagwan. This Bharat, Jada Bharat, he became a deer. But he remembered his past life, so he remembered Bhagwan. Now they are able to remember Bhagwan and we taking human birth not able to remember Bhagwan. So he says the greatest blessing of human life is Narayana Smriti. Again, see this first line when it says Atma Sammitaha, we should never separate these two things. They are not different. Narayana Smriti means Atma Smriti, both are same only. Continuously remember I am Brahman, pure consciousness, I am not this body, or Remember that the Lord alone is real, the whole universe is an appearance of Bhagavan alone, and He is in my own heart. Narayana Smriti. These three things are the glory of human life. And all the three are actually leading to remembrance of the Lord, abidance in the Lord only. What is the first one? Sankhya Yoga Abhyam. Sankhya Yoga is through self-knowledge, I learn to withdraw the attention of the mind from the finite and attach it to the infinite. Sankhya Yoga Abhyam. Then while engaging in the world, Swadharma Parinishthaya. Live in the world doing the duties, dedicating it to Bhagavan. And what is not my duty, don't do. What Gita Bhagavan said, Niyatam Kuru Karmatvam. And then what to do? Remember Bhagavan. All the scriptures I study finally culminate in love of God. That's all. If love of God is not there, throw away all the books. What will I do? It is only increasing. You know, Shankaracharya gives the example is, it is like donkey carrying golden bricks. For a donkey, what is that golden brick? No value, is extra burden only. We study also, Bhakti Sudha humne padha, Narad Bhakti Sutra humne padha, Manas Bhakti Sutra padha. Bhagwan ki bhakti, wo abhi to aayegi. Ante Narayana Smriti, he said. What should be remembered at the end of the life? Narayana only. Bhagwan, do you remember? Parikshit Raja, for him it is not new. He to went away to remember Bhagwan only. So we may wonder, what is so great that, you know, Sukadev Maharaj told Parikshit Raja that he did not know. This is the importance of a guru. When we hear from the mouth of a guru who is established in the truth, that knowledge has a completely different impact, and ignorance goes only when you hear from such a master. Till then it is information. Gurudev saying Tattvamasi has a different impact. Because established in the truth, those words have a different power. In day-to-day life also we see that happening or not. Somebody who is practicing tells you. Simplest example, somebody who has followed a particular diet and lost some 7 kilos or 10 kilos. If that person tells you this works for me, what will you do? It will touch your heart, no? Because the result is visible. You know, this person was like this, now he is like this, so that diet is working. Same if somebody who is not practicing tells you, what will you do? Okay. It won't touch. Ordinary things in the world, if that happens, this is the highest knowledge. So though it is the same thing, there is nothing new absolutely that he has said. But the guru who is established in jnana, bhakti, vairagya, from the mouth of the guru, one has to listen to that. Acharya mukhar sharanam kuryat. So for Parikshit Raja, it is that. Now one very nice meaning of this. Ante Narayana Smritihi. So what we think, Ante Narayana Smriti means Antakale, meaning at the time of death. But you know what is the meaning of Anta? Every single moment. Because every single moment is an end. Anta doesn't come only at the end of the body. The previous moment dies, the next moment is born. So the death of every single moment, meaning moment by moment I should remember the Lord. Ante Narayana Smriti means that. Meaning through the life, if I remember Bhagwan, then also at the end of the life I will remember Bhagwan. It will not happen only just at the end of the life. Dongre Maharaj has written very nicely, Mrityu ko sudharna hai to jivan ko sudharo. Jivan nahi sudharega to mrityu nahi sudharegi. Jivan ke sudharne se hi mrityu sudhar sakti hai. At that time when we are going to die, where to? How will I remember the Lord if I don't have the habit? Habitually, the mind, whatever it thinks of throughout the life and where the bhav is, not even mechanically thinking, the bhav. Where the bhav is, that only the mind will think. So if I feel that, you know, this person I am attached to, now that person only will come to the mind. Because the bhav is for that person. This I could not achieve, some regret, I am stuck with that regret. Now the bhav is on that regret. Have we not seen so many people who are not able to leave the body because they are attached to something, to some person. Now till that person doesn't come, they won't go. And the moment that person comes, gone. Or you bring that thing, gone. So bhav, where the bhav is there. So he says Ante Narayana Smriti means that what one should do, one should remember through the day, every minute, as much as one can. But the challenge always comes when our mind says, but we have work to do. Are you, but work is for what? How much ever we can remember, and that work also we dedicate to Bhagwan, then over. The best part is that much. So Ante Narayana Smriti, very, very nice expression this is. Prayena Munayo Rajan Nivritta Vidhi Sheshataha Vidhi Shedhataha. Nairgunyastha Ramantesma Gunanukathane Harehe. This is very good. Even these great rishis, they remember that Supreme Lord who are established in the absolute. Even such great rishis who cannot be told anything, Vidhi and Nishere, who have gone beyond Vidhi and Nished, who have established themselves in the absolute truth, even those people, what they do? They delight in discourses of the Lord. Nirgunyastha Ramantesma. They are reveling in the Nirgun Nirakar Parabrahma Tattva. Guna Anukathane Hare. They also are very pleased to remember the Guna and Katha of the Lord. Meaning, this is the glory of devotion. So more we continue in our next class. Om natatra suryo bhati na chandra tarakam nema vidyuto bhanti kuto yamagnihi tameva bhantam anubhati sarvam tasya bhasa sarvamidam vibhati bolye radhavara krishna chandra bhagwan ki jai. Shri Sadgurunath Maharaj ki jai. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.